here's White Shark Bob. He was here off Nantucket. Suddenly, he made a couple of a very southerly track way down here offshore, off the shelf. And then this is here on December 3rd. This is a little bit unusual for these guys to go offshore like this.
But he's really stuck to the coast, you know, between Canada and North Florida until now.
So this is not unprecedented for mature males, but we haven't seen Bob do this one.
To be clear, the males don't seem to do the real big loops offshore like the females do that go out to all the way out halfway across the ocean, the Mid-Atlantic Ridge. But you're right. I mean, males occasionally do this. And is it because they're so much bigger, they're able to handle conditions better?
So they could go, potentially, they can go into deeper water and handle deeper, colder water more so than a juvenile white shark because of their size?
Yeah, I mean, remember that white sharks essentially are warm-blooded. They're able to keep their body temperature above the ambient seawater. And as they get bigger, they can hold heat even longer. So he could be going very deep and exploiting that really rich food source of mesopelagic prey. You know, actually deep water, there's a lot more life than you'd think. It's not a desert at all. It's actually filled with food. I don't know, we have to keep an eye on him and see what he does from this point on.